Greetings, viewers all over the world. Welcome to Charis Missionary Church Prayer Line with Prophetess T.E. Makananitaye in Charis Missionary Church. We believe that as you're using the medium that you're using to watch us, distance is not a barrier. You can touch your screen and believe that as the woman of God, we'll be praying for those who are here. You too, you'll be delivered. You'll be free from whatever the obstacle that you're facing in your life in Jesus' name. And today we are with Ms. Matlhatsi Silepe. She's 28. She's having chronic headache. And she'll be explaining to us or telling us how did it affect her, ma'am. You registered that you're having chronic headache. Can you please tell us how was it affecting your life? When did you know that you're having a chronic headache? Because eventually when you have a headache, you believe that it will go.
It first started with an accident. I had an accident where I fell in a mall from third floor to negative one ground. So since then, it hasn't been bad. I've been taking painkillers, but it will go away. So starting this year, it has been bad. So when I'm taking painkillers and everything to be relieved from the pain, it doesn't go away. So nothing works.
And what motivated you to come here to be prayed for by the woman of God?
Because I believe I'll get healing after getting prayed for.
And what are the words of encouragement that you can give to the viewers out there as you are a Charis member registering for prayer line? Eventually you've seen many people being healed. What can you say to other people out there?
There's life here. Yeah.
We thank you so much. I believe that as you are here and as the word of God says that by his stripes we are healed, I believe that today is the woman of God we're praying for you. Your healing shall be permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And also here with us, we are with Miss Julia Kudiha. He's having chronic headache, general body pains from 1980, and she'll be telling us how did this affect her. Mama, can you please tell us, you wrote that you are having a chronic headache. How did it affect your life? Lingwadile re lena le chronic headache. Le opa ke tlhoko ka metla. Ile affecta jwang mo bophelong ba lena since 1980?
Sometimes u thoma thotlhoho. O sa re ke tlhoko ke mmele. Mmele o ya ko spinal ko thoko mona the whole body. Mona pelo e betha ka speed.
Mama, she's explaining to us that this is affecting her in a way that it starts as a head and sometimes it goes to the spinal cord and eventually it also goes to the heart. So this is affecting her so badly. And Lingwe, you wrote that you are having general body pains. Lingwe, you wrote that you are having general
body pains.
And today ka ha le le mo Charis Missionary Church la dumela gore ka e batlo le rapella le tlo fola. Mama re dumela le le na re mo motlha batlo le rapella le tlo fola ka lebitso la Jesu.
Ke a dumela.
Amen. And also here with us we're with Miss Nema Konde Lufuno. She's having painful legs and eye problem from 2002. Can you please tell us how did it affect you? Let's start with the painful legs. How did it affect your life? What are the things that you couldn't do because of this problem?
No, Tom and Goto, one mlenje wa right. Hatevela mlenje wa left. Uba hapo zuitisa urichipinga chote. Atikonu uchimbra long distance. Ndipuangaru una makare ofisa mlenjeni. Chingwe chipinga ndipuangaru ukotabu wanga zinerete. Ndingava hapa usuka hapo geteni. Ndoji ya kamisi bo 10 minutes. Ndaba ndi chivoto umbrori kamisi ndina ulazi ya swigiri kana ulazi ya marambo ngauri. Ndingaba ofa maduwa mara, rumushumo, ni mara ngalabu na ndichi santa mbete. Ndisi ngosuka na geti ni. Ndi familia nje ichibaba.
Our sister, she's explaining to us that this problem of the legs started on the right hand side, and while she was saying that it's only the right leg, it also came to the left side, and this has affected her in a way that she cannot walk long distance from here to the gate of the church. It can take her 10 minutes. And she's also telling us that this pain was so terrible that at times she will feel that she's having colds, hot colds in her feet, and at other times she will feel like she's been pierced with needles. So this has been affecting her so badly. And you also wrote that you are having a problem with eyes. How did this eyes affect your life?
Okay, ndi chika the end kamilenje butungwenda ndi chipupa kamilenje ndi chipa uchipisa I zwin affect mbiluni wa wana uri ndiko chimbira ndiko bva mushumo na mitodzi ko bvandisa kuno chimbira zvino kama to ndo vha muthu o shumesa nga computer 3 and a half years mara nda dijia license yanga ndisina mangira asimara ano maduwa na msi ndichivara kamisi bibili nda zubwa nzuri atitakono obona last year January nga zifo nrofe ilano renewal license nda dhibu zauri kaya nambe ipeze the whole year ndi doi renewal again ndono dhurabiliri.
Our sister, she's explaining to us that adding that she's feeling pains in her legs, this has affected her that she couldn't walk when she's coming back from work. And she's also explaining to us that this problem of the eyes, she's been using a computer for 3.5 years, and she also took her license while she did not have a sign that she's having a high problem. But last time when she went to write, she failed.
To renew a license.
To renew her license, she failed because eventually they did the test of the eyes and they realized that she's having a problem with her eyes.
Especially this one, the right one. Mm.
And were you taking any medicine for the eyes?
No, I was using the eyeglasses only.
And what about the painful legs? Were you taking any medication?
No, sometimes I'm not sure.
Our sister, she's explaining to us that she was not taking any medication for the leg problem, but this has affected her because each and every time she will take hot water to put the legs, but the pain will still be there. And at times she will take cold water, but still the pain would be there. And at times when she comes back from work, she would be crying because of the pain that she would be feeling in her legs. And as you are here today, do you believe that you're going to be healed?
I'm not.
And what motivated you to come here in Charis Missionary Church?
And the Gary Charis in Dotomo Yvonantia, and since 2009 in the Dandaikaraka Uba to 2014, Nabonam Zimach Boporo Raba to Nandemo about Tubanoporo Zinji, Nabonam Zimach Chizava to Nazuana Zorimini, Musinoful Peram Dindawam Zimu, Nidopora, Ganan Dowanangauri, Ditotomo Furperam Dindawam Zimu, Tomor Musi Anta Berera, Nendopora.
Our sister, she's telling us that she does believe that today, as she'll be prayed for, she'll be healed. And she's telling us that the thing that motivated her to come here is because of she was watching Charles TV when she was still at home. And she believed that the moment she comes in being touched by the man of God, she will be healed. And even today, she still believes that as she will be touched, she will be healed in Jesus' name. Ma'am, we believe with you that as you are here, as the woman of God, we're praying for you, your healing shall be permanent and you shall surely come back with a testimony in Jesus' name. And also here with us, you're with Miss Maria Makgato. She's having high blood, sugar, diabetes, and stroke from 2012. Let's start with high blood pressure. When did you know that you were having high blood pressure, and were you taking any medication?
Yes, I discovered that I'm having high blood pressure when I was attacked in class. I did nursing, and I'm disabled to work as a nurse because of this high blood pressure and sugar diabetes. The two of them made me to have stroke, and then I'm unable to finish my practical work. So they are denying me to give me my certificate. And then, yes, and they are uncontrolled. Even though I use medication, they are uncontrolled. So they are disturbing me in my life. And then there's no way I can earn a living without money. And then I can get a job today, tomorrow. They say you are unable. I'm having difficulty in working also because of this problem. Then to me.
And the fact that this sugar diabetes and high blood pressure that caused stroke in your life, it has made your life to be stagnant because eventually you cannot get a job because you are not having the qualification. How does it affect you spiritually, emotionally, physically?
I'm always having a full stress because I studied and passed all my exams, and then only practical. I'm running short of 4%. Only that 4% is disabling me, is enabling me to get a certificate. So it's like I didn't go to school, and I'm having a problem. I'm always in stress.
And as you are here today, and as the woman of God, we're praying for you. Do you believe that you're going to be healed?
Yes, yes, I believe so.
And as you are here, I believe that there are many people out there who are having the same situation that you are facing in your life. What are the words of encouragement that you can give to them? As I believe that as you are here, you today, your case is over in Jesus' name.
The only thing I can tell them, they must stick to God and believe that each and everything is the beginning and at the end. In Jesus' name, everything will be fulfilled, as long as you believe in God as your Savior.
We give glory to Jesus for your life. We believe that today is the woman of God. We're praying for you. Your healing shall be permanent, and I believe that God shall grant you your heart desire in Jesus' name.
Thank you very much.
And also here with us, here with Miss Catherine Bopilo. She's having arthritis, high blood pressure, and stroke. Mama, lingwajur lina le high blood pressure, arthritis, le stroke. Lekarabujar le tumilutubar lina le problem yening. Can you please tell us, when did you know of this problem?
Okay.
Mama, ningasichilo kuti niyazi ni arthritis na high blood pressure na le stroke.
Izinto zinhlupha kakhulu nekhanda lingiphethe kwehle nganqanye kuze kuyophuma phansi onyaweni. Uhamba ngengalo, ingalo kangikwazi ukuyiphakamisa, namehlo futhi abuhlungu, kanti noshukela ungiphethe, iBP futhi qola amathambo.
Mama, she's explaining to us that she's having a pain from the upper shoulder to the lower leg. And she's also telling us that she's having a problem with her eyes. And also this has affected her again because she's having a BP stroke and also arthritis. And mama, ningasichilo ukuthi le arthritis in affecte kanjani empilweni yenu?
Ngithi ngicela nje umfundisi ubani na angiphumkhuleko manje nakho ungasawutholanga keke esekuhlukaniweke manje bengikhalela ngoba ikhono bekungisukuse ekhaya kangangokuthi bengisuka kude le eMondlo.
Mama, she's saying that this has affected her so much, and she's just praying that today, as she will be prayed for, she shall be healed because she's coming far from home in KZN. And Mama, ningasitshela ukuthi ini eniyenze ukuthi nize la namhlanje Charis Missionary Church nithi nizothandazela? Yini eni encourage ukuthi nize la?
Ukungqabi ingqakile impela yiyo le BP namehla waboni kahle. Ikhanda elingaphuma elingiphatha zonke insuku ngiphuza amaphilisi kakuzwakali, amathambo ngidla amaphilisi amathambo akuzwakali. Manje yabona nje kuhamba konke uhlangothi lolu, ikhona ukungilethile impela lapha ngoba angisakhoni ngisho ukwenzani ekhaya.
Mommy, she's telling us that because of this pain of headache, she has been taking medication, and the reason why she says because of when she's here, it's her last hope, and she's believing that today God will heal her in Jesus' name. Mama Natis, niyathemba ukuthi namhlanje as bazonithandazela nizophola ngegama lika Jesu, and nizobuya nomfakazi ngegama lika Jesu.
Yebo, amen.
Viewers all over the world, as you can see, these are the people who came here in Charis Missionary Church to be prayed for by the woman of God. And if you too love to see yourself being part of the people who are here to be prayed for, you can call the contacts that are following on your screen, 011-027-7962, 011-027-7962. Or if you are out of the country, you can use our country code, which is +27110275. +271 107 7962. And we believe that as the woman of God, we pray for those who are here. You too, distance is not a barrier. You can touch a screen and you will be healed in Jesus' name. Stay connected to see the woman of God praying for those who are here. Amen. Lately, our sister told us that this problem of a chronic headache, it has affected her in a way that she can't do anything. Even though she's taking medication, she cannot be healed. We believe that today is the woman of God. She's praying for her. She's healed in Jesus' name. And lately, we interviewed our mother. She told us that this problem that she's having in her life, it has affected her that even during the night, she's having sleepless night because of this chronic headache and body pains in the body. We believe that as the woman of God is ministering healing in her life, she is healed in Jesus' name. And our sister lately told us that she has been working with a computer for 3.5 years, and she did not know that she would eventually have a high problem, and she just knew when she was going to renew her license. We believe that today is the woman of God. She's praying for her. She's totally healed, and she's coming back with a testimony. And the pain that she has been explaining that it made her cry, we believe that it is gone in Jesus' name. And our mother told us that the problem that she has been having, it has made her to stop her career at work. They don't want to give her a certificate because of this stroke that is making her to never be able to work. We believe that right now, as the woman of God is delivering her, that demon that was blocking her destiny, it is gone in Jesus' name. As the woman of God and the man of God always teaches that everybody needs deliverance, we believe that you too, wherever you are touching your screen for your deliverance, your healing, your breakthrough, and we believe that indeed you shall surely come back to tell us that God has healed you in Jesus' name. Our mother told her that she's coming from KZN, and this place is her last bus stop. We believe that as the woman of God prayed for her, she's healed and permanently in Jesus' name. Stay connected and stay blessed until next week.